Number 12. Shrunken Heads. The Jivaroan people of Peru and Ecuador are known for creating bizarre artifacts called santa, which are shrunken heads. The practice originally had religious implications. Shrinking the head of an enemy would compel their spirit to serve and prevent it from taking revenge. The process involved removing the skin from a skull and then placing it on a wooden ball to maintain its shape. The fat was taken out, the lips were sewn shut, and reeds were placed in the nostrils. The head was then boiled in water with herbs containing tannins. Sand and hot rocks were used to dry off the shrunken head while it was molded to retain human features. Oddly enough, the collector demand for these artifacts was met with a sharp increase in tribal killings. It's actually where the term head hunting originates from. Number 11. Muta Museum. A collection donated by Dr. Thomas Dent Muta in 1858 to the College of Physicians of Philadelphia eventually grew to a museum with over 20,000 specimens. Some of them include creepy items like hands afflicted by gout or a baby born without a skull, as well as organs with massive cysts or tumors. The Muta Museum is the only place in the world where visitors can view slides of Albert Einstein's brain on permanent display. Other notable items include vertebrae samples from John Wilkes Booth, who assassinated US President Abraham Lincoln, and a section of the brain of Charles J. Guiteau, the assassin of President James A. Garfield. The museum also houses a large number of full skeletons, the most famous of which is arguably that of Harry Eastlack. He suffered from an extremely rare condition called fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva, which meant that the bone repair mechanism in his body worked in overdrive. The rare mutation turned his muscle tissue to bone, and by the time of his death, Eastlack's entire body had ossified. Number 10. Dried cat. An old practice in European cultures involved placing the body of a dried or desiccated cat inside the walls of a newly built home. These creepy artifacts are frequently found in the walls of old buildings in North America, Europe, and the British Isles. The animal remains are often discovered in poses that suggest they're in the middle of an attack. The root of this practice is the belief that cats possess a sixth sense that enables them to peer into the spiritual world. They were placed sometimes alive, but mostly post-mortem, inside the walls of houses so that they could use their purported psychic abilities to ward off evil spirits. Number 9. Crying Boy. The Crying Boy is the umbrella name for mass-produced prints of paintings from Italian artist Giovanni Bragolin. All the works display portraits of tearful young children. They were widely distributed, particularly in Britain, starting from the 1950s. Then in the 1980s, a purported curse became attached to the Crying Boy, as firefighters frequently found undamaged copies in the remains of houses that had burned down. It was said that hanging the print, which already had a rather ominous connotation due to the crying theme, would doom a home to a fiery fate. The alleged curse gained enough momentum that readers of The Sun were sending in prints and the newspaper was organizing mass bonfires. It was later claimed that the prints were treated with a fire retardant varnish. A subsequent theory proposed that the string holding the painting would burn first, causing it to land face down on the floor and be protected. Still, none of that explained why the Crying Boy paintings were the only ones to remain undamaged in the fires. Number 8. Swansea Devil. In the late 1890s, several architectural designs were considered for the rebuilding of St. Mary's Church in the centre of Swansea, Wales. When his submission was rejected, one local architect viewed it as a slight against his skill. Years later, he bought a row of cottages next to the church. He had them torn down and built a red brick building that housed the brewery offices. Atop the building, he placed a wooden figure of a grinning devil that faced the church. The architect claimed that his devil would remain laughing even after St. Mary's was destroyed. His words proved prophetic, as the church was brought down by bombings during World War II, while the Swansea Devil continued to grin over its burnt remains. The church was eventually rebuilt, while the sinister wood carving found a place in the Swansea Museum. Number 7. Hand of Glory. The Hand of Glory was an artifact that, according to old European beliefs, had supernatural powers that its holder could benefit from. It involved a severed hand, taken from a criminal who died in the gallows. If the person was sentenced for murder, then it had to be the hand that committed the crime. Once removed, it was dried and pickled. A candle made from the fat of the same criminal was then placed in the hand of glory. In some versions, the wick came from the dead person's hair. It had the power to render motionless anyone to whom it was presented. The hand of glory was said to unlock any door, which is why it was of particular interest to criminals. In some versions of the myth, the hand would only give light to its holder and could only be put out with milk. Number 6. Head of Peter Curtin. Peter Curtin is arguably one of the most monstrous serial killers in history. Named the Vampire of Dusseldorf, he abused and murdered his victims in brutal ways. Curtin would horribly maim them and sometimes drink the blood out of their wounds for sexual gratification. Described as the king of sexual perverts. In 1931, he was convicted on 9 counts of murder as well as 7 counts of attempted murder and sentenced to death by beheading. As he was walking towards the guillotine, accompanied by his psychiatrist, Curtin uttered what has become one of the most chilling serial killer quotes. He asked him, "Tell me, after my head is chopped off, will I still be able to hear, at least for a moment, the sound of my own blood gushing from the stump of my neck? That would be the pleasure to end all pleasures." Curtin never showed any remorse for his crimes and, perhaps most shockingly, was declared legally sane by the psychiatrist who'd interviewed him. After his execution, Curtin's head was bisected and mummified while his brain was analyzed, but no physical explanation was found to account for his deranged mind. Curtin's skull is presently on display at the Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum in Wisconsin. The sight of the head split in two is exceedingly more terrifying when considering the story behind it. Number 5. Fiji Mermaid. A Fiji mermaid was an item often featured as a sideshow attraction, which was presented as the mummified body of a creature with the upper half of a mammal and the lower half of a fish. The original had bared teeth, pendulous breasts on its chest, and a fish tail. It was displayed in the 1840s at Barnum's American Museum in New York. The supposed mermaid was said to have been caught near the Fiji Islands in the South Pacific. Several replicas of the Fiji mermaid have since been made and exhibited under various pretenses. In most cases, what the item actually displayed was the torso of a juvenile monkey sewn to the back half of a fish. Number 4. Ubaid figurines. Not much is known about the Ubaid period, a prehistoric period of Mesopotamia going back to 6500 to 3800 BC. Some of the most mysterious Ubaid artifacts are figurines displaying what appears to be lizard heads on broad-shouldered human torsos. One notable representation is of a female breastfeeding a lizard-headed infant. No one knows what they represent, but theories range from religious symbolism or body modifications to fringe claims of alien hybrids. Number 3. Frog coffin. During restoration work for several churches in Finland, a number of strange artifacts were discovered in the form of miniature coffins with frogs inside them. These finds varied, as in one the frog's mouth had been sewn shut, and in another the animal had been impaled with a needle with white thread on it. The practice of burying frogs in coffins is described in Finnish folklore as a form of magic. The majority of purported powers involve repelling evil intentions or curing ailments, but there are also writings about how frog coffins can be used to harm and even kill. In these cases, an object from the intended victim was required. Creepier still, while frogs were the most common animal remains involved in the rituals, there are reports of squirrels, pikes, and even human fetuses being used. Today's topic was inspired by Deadly Venom King. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Necropants. Necropants are artifacts from Icelandic witchcraft, believed to have the power of producing endless money. Whoever wanted to make their own necropants, or nabro, had to get permission from a living person to use their skin after they died. The skin had to be flayed in one piece from the waist down. In the scrotum, the wearer had to place a coin stolen from a poor widow, along with a magical symbol written on a piece of paper. The belief was that as long as the original coin wasn't removed, the pants would continue to draw money. If the wearer wanted to transfer the necropants, the new owner had to step into each leg immediately, or the artifact would lose its power. Official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. Some of it is to die for. Number 1. Haunted Dolls. Throughout history, there have been several dolls which earned infamy for allegedly being haunted. One such example is Robert, a doll that served as inspiration for Chucky, the murderous doll, which originally appeared in the 1988 horror movie Child's Play. It was alleged that Robert had supernatural powers and could move, change facial expressions, and make giggling noises. Another creepy artifact is a Raggedy Ann doll said to be possessed by the spirit of a deceased girl named Annabelle. According to its original owner, the doll exhibited malicious and frightening behavior. Australia's Museums Victoria recently released a photo of a life-size baby doll that came into their possession and which had completely blackened eyes. It was compared to an alien-human hybrid. Staff reportedly found its face to be so creepy that they had it covered. Thanks for watching. Would you rather spend a month with the Annabelle doll by your bedside or give up all social media for that same time period? Let us know in the comments section below.